All right, fellow pots, welcome back to the channel. This is going to be my first video here, Microsoft Flight Sim 2020, and we're going to be talking about a couple things. The first big thing, the most important part here, it's going to be the OpenXR development update that was brought for the OpenXR development tools for Microsoft Flight Sim 2020. Guys, this is kind of a big deal because we've been having a lot of issues, and I say we, I think most of the community, with crash of desktops and just WMR OpenXR not being smooth, and I really believe that this does solve that issue, guys. So if it's your first time here, I want to say welcome to the channel. Thank you for watching. My name is Jose. I'm an air traffic controller. I'm a huge VR flight sim nerd, and we're going to be departing here technically X-ray 44 out of the port of Miami in Microsoft Flight Sim, but let's get into this real fast. Here we go. Now, guys, if I'm talking way too fast, I do apologize. I just had some coffee, and I'm super excited to get this content out for you guys. By the way, if you drink coffee or Red Bull or something, let me know in the comments below. Or if it's a beer, let me know. What are you drinking right now? I feel like getting some more coffee. I'm not going to lie. But anyways, guys, the big thing here, it's the OpenXR development tool for Windows Mixed Reality has been updated. I'm going to throw it here on the screen somewhere. This is what it looks like, and you get it in the Microsoft Store. So keep this in mind. Number one, this is only for Reverb G2 / WMR users, right? So if you have the Quest 2, this will not necessarily help you. It's not going to affect you. Also, your crash of desktops over there are probably for another reason. Number two, we got a crazy tailwind here. Looks flaps are up. Let's keep going. The second big thing is that you can download Windows Mixed Reality and have been running Microsoft Flight Sim here in VR with your Reverb G2 and not have downloaded this. You do not need this software. So keep that in mind. This software actually is going to allow you to turn on preview runtime mode to on, which from my understanding, it's going to allow you to run the beta build of these drivers, so to speak, that are running in the background of this API here. So again, by downloading the OpenXR tools, turning the preview runtime on, you're going to stop your crash of desktops. Now, I can verify this because I've entered and exited VR now at least probably 20 times, and I have not crashed Microsoft Flight Sim 2020, which this is amazing. So I'm not the only one to report this. We've been getting multiple reports of this improved experience here and not having those crashes. So definitely take a look at that. Now, the second part of this is going to be that if you run the reprojection mode, again, if you haven't been a fan of it in the past, I'm asking you to give it a shot, take a look at it, and see if it runs any better, because I definitely noticed that it did. In fact, I was really impressed by it. You know, whether I fly the Airbus out of Miami here with a Latin VFR scenery, or I fly the Skyhawk over here, the OpenXR preview runtime mode on with the reprojection mode has honestly been really, really good. So it's one of those things that, you know, when a couple of us start really saying, hey guys, this is helping out, you know, here in the Facebook group and also the Discord group from VR Flight Sim Guy, you know, when you see a pattern, you definitely want to share that information and you know, bring more awareness to that, just because it's obviously helping people out. Now, finally, the last thing I'll bring up here is that I'm running a 12900K with an RTX 3090 ROG Strix and DDR5 at 5200 megahertz. Now, I'm going to have more information on that, and if you're wondering how the performance is and how it's been for me, the quick recap is it's absolutely amazing and has been worth it. For me, I'm going to say absolutely yes. You know, it's just been really just impressive at how enjoyable the sim is at the high resolution, because honestly, you guys are able to really enjoy Microsoft Flight Sim, you know, at some fairly nice resolutions without, you know, a lot of issues, even though you don't have a 3090. It's not a requirement. It's just one of those things that allows you to tweak the sim, you know, in a certain direction, a little bit more, bump up certain graphics, the trees, the fidelity, what, and so forth. So I just want to share that with you guys. I'm going to have more information on that on my build here coming up soon. So again, guys, I hope that helps you guys. I hope this content is of value to you. If you do appreciate it, please leave me a thumbs up, subscribe, you know, write a comment, give me some feedback. Let me know how it's been running for you. You know, it really does make a difference for me if you guys do that. So I want to say thank you so much. Anyways, guys, I'll let you go before I keep rambling on forever. Take it easy, guys. Later.